Hi, Kapamilya. I'm Ginger Conejero with today's headlines from BA.
After narrowly losing her 2018 Texas congressional bid, Gina Ortiz Jones remains poised to win in 2020 and become the first Filipino-American elected to the U.S. Congress. Recently, this Fil-Am candidate made a trip outside of Texas to meet supporters all the way in San Francisco. Jones is once again running to represent the 23rd Congressional District in Texas. She nearly won the seat in one of the closest races in the 2018 elections, losing to Republican incumbent William Hurd by only 926 votes. Jones says she is more motivated to win.
And despite being massively outspent, the fact that we came that close shows that, you know, our message resonates. Our vision, you know, right, my desire to make sure that we have more health care, not less, making sure that everyone has access to opportunities, right, the same ones that allowed me to grow up healthy, get an education, and serve our country. I look forward to protecting those for the next generation of Americans.
President of the U.S. Pinoys for Good Governance, Rodel Rodes, hosted a fundraiser for Jones and is confident Jones will win in 2020.
Well, I told her that we've got the Filipino community that's willing to support her because she will be the first Pinay elected to the U.S. Congress.
In Orange County, California, Asian American and Pacific Islander voters got a chance to meet with three presidential hopefuls, one of them with Asian heritage, another with Pacific Islander roots, even a childhood connection to the Philippines. The AAPI Victory Fund and Asian Americans Rising PAC hosted the forum, which brought out Chinese American Andrew Yang, Hawaii Congresswoman Tulsi Gabbard, and billionaire businessman Tom Steyer for fireside chats. Each of them had the chance to address the AAPI community and their pressing needs.
For people who are here and undocumented, I'm for path to citizenship.
Steyer expressed his excitement on qualifying for the October debate.
It is really, really important and interesting, and I'm actually extremely energized both by this.
Gabbard talked about her multicultural and multi-religious roots. She also attended an all-girls Christian missionary school in the Philippines.
This is the accurate way to explain my ethnicity and my ancestry, and they haven't done it. They haven't done it, which I think points to just, unfortunately, how dismissive, present company excluded, a lot of our mainstream media is to, you know, who we are, how diverse we are as people.
And from politics, we go to fashion. New York is considered to be the fashion capital of the world. And in the middle of the Big Apple's busy Times Square, the I Got You fashion show closed by Filipino designer Rocky Gathercole. Rocky Gathercole's designs have been worn by stars like Beyonce, Katy Perry, Lady Gaga, Nicki Minaj, Gwen Stefani, and Paris Hilton.
As a Filipino, talagang sobrang proud ako dahil napili nila ako to be part of the show. And this is first time in Times Square na gawin nila to. Ako pa ang finale. Sobrang nakakatuwa. I'm so happy.
It was absolutely breathtaking. It was emotion woven into fabric. And, you know, I think anybody that had the honor of wearing that line is truly blessed.
We're keeping you connected to news that matters most, so be sure to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and subscribe to our BA YouTube channel. I'm Ginger Conejero. We'll see you again later today with another BA News Break.